For this video, I wanted to talk about using the Midas DN4816-O StageCONNECT interface with the Behringer XR18 or Midas MR18. The Midas StageCONNECT box can be used as a digital splitter if you're using the mixer as an in-ear monitor console. I'll talk about how it works, the settings you'll need to know, and the pros and cons when using this as your splitter versus an analog splitter. Besides the StageCONNECT connections, the Midas box has Ultranet ports. The XR18 also has an Ultranet port. Ultranet uses standard Ethernet cables. On the rear of the Midas DN4816-O, there is a power input connector. You'll need to use the included power supply when connecting to the Ultranet port like we need to here. The USB port is for firmware updates, so we can skip this. We have in and out Ultranet ports. We need to connect to the in. The StageConnect ports are for using this with a device that also has StageConnect abilities. There are no StageConnect ports on the XR18. There are two switches. We want to set this switch to Ultranet. And we want to set the output mode to be individual. Now we need to go into our control software and set our output routing. On XR Edit, you need to choose In Out and then tab over to Ultranet. For splitting the channels to front of house, there's really only two main options to consider, either analog or input. Input sends a signal after any soft patching you might have done. Analog takes the signal directly after the preamp you are connected to. The analog tap will send input 1 on the XR18 to output 1 of the DN4816-O and continue with 2-2, 3-3, 4-4, all the way to input 16 to output 16 on the DN4816-O. So what is soft patching? Soft patching is when you assign the physical inputs on the front of the XR18 to a different mixer channel rather than the matching input. So let's look at mixing station. For those using mixing station, to get to routing, click the two arrows at the top. Then choose output routing. Now choose Ultranet. For a 1-to-1 patch, choose the Ultranet P16 out and then the channel it will connect to. And you can change the tap as the next step or leave it if it's already what you want. Do this for all 16 available Ultranet channels. If you're not doing any soft patching, then either option is basically the same. But that said, I would recommend analog. That way, no matter what you connect to each channel is exactly matched on the outputs of the Midas box. You also have the option of plus mute. I would suggest not using the plus mute option. That way, when you mute a channel on stage, the output to front of house is still active for front of house. You might be done listening to a channel, but front of house might still want to hear it. Right-click to choose the option that you prefer. That's it for the settings. Now you just need to connect your fan-to-fan audio snake from the Midas box to the house audio snake. Let's talk pros and cons. One huge pro is how small and compact the package is. Only 4 total rack spaces. If you need to make your IEM rack as small as possible, this is hard to beat. Another pro. There's just the one Ethernet cable to get the signals from the Behringer to the splitter. Another benefit comes into play if you're using any USB inputs, like tracks. This passes that signal straight through as well. You just need to route the USB channel or channels to your chosen Ultranet outputs. In this example, let's say we have USB coming in on USB 15 and 16 and need to send it out 15 and 16 of the digital splitter. Just click those boxes on the graph, make sure the tap points are correct, and you're done. And while we're on the subject of USB, although Ultranet is limited to 16 outputs, even if our USB is coming in on the stereo aux channels, which are 17 and 18, we can still route those to come out whatever outputs you'd want. We do that by assigning those two USB inputs to any open Ultranet outputs. In this example, 15 and 16. But there are cons. Since this is a digital split, you're sending your signal to front of house after the preamps. You'll need your preamps set correctly and left alone before front of house is sound checked, or you'll change the levels front of house is getting when you readjust channel gains. And if your channels are clipping, front of house will get that same clip signal and it can only be corrected at your end. Another con is getting the routing page wrong. There are other options in routing, like post EQ, which would mean you'd be sending front of house process channels instead of the raw signals. Front of house generally wants and needs their own control over those things. Another con is redundancy. With an analog split, if your monitor mixer loses power or dies, signals keep going to front of house unaffected. If your monitor mixer loses power with a digital split, front of house gets nothing. Another point to be aware of that isn't exactly a pro or a con necessarily, this outputs a line level signal versus the mic level signal that comes from an analog splitter. So it'll be a hotter signal going into the front of house console. Front of house will just need to adjust the front of house console gain accordingly. The Midas DN4816-O is so affordable and makes for such a neat and compact package that as long as you understand the cons, they can easily be managed. I'll leave links to these below. Here are a couple videos talking about IEM rig cabling management as well as system interconnections. Leave any comments or questions below. Thanks for watching. Thanks to the patrons. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time.